Time for some fun crafts. I'm going to DIY Alice in Wonderland themed decor. We're going to make the doorknob with the door and eat me sign to be used.
So for making the door from Alice in Wonderland, I've taken a rectangular piece of cardboard. This is approximately 5 inches by 7 inches or 5 inches by 8 inches. Then I have cut out some thin strips of cardboard to form the frame of my door. So these are approximately 3/4 of an inch wide and the same length, two pieces, same length for the side frames and a similar width and the same length as the width of this door. So now let's first cut it neatly. To get the proper look of the frame, I'm marking the diagonal line. And we'll cut it out. So that it sits neatly like a frame of a door. You can trim it as per requirement. Next, I'm using some PVA glue to glue the three pieces in place. So we have the frame of the door ready. Now for the door, I've taken another piece of cardboard and this is of a different color shade than the frame, so that it looks a little distinct, and I have cut it to a size that it fits inside this frame. Again, I'm going to glue this here. Some PVA glue, and I've glued it right in. So this way the structure is ready.
Now I'm using some acrylic paint and I'm diluting the paint with some little water so that it acts like a stain and can flow easily over the cardboard surface and shade my door. For the door frame, I'm using black paint. I've diluted it slightly and I'm making these marks that are seen on wooden surfaces, deep dark marks here. And I'll go along the frame structure so that the structure becomes more prominent. I'll dilute it further and stain it further, enhance the shade sides likewise. My today's video is part of the fairy tale inspired challenge that is hosted by Annie from the channel Indie Annie Jones and co-hosted by Sandy from the channel Sandy Mackenzie Lappamille DIY. I'll put links to both the ladies' channels and to the playlist in the description box of the video. For the door, I picked some red paint and I mixed it with a little black and I started making the lines on the door. If they are irregular, it doesn't matter. If it's like straight lines, then it's made by a very sharp carpenter, and if it's like irregular lines, it's more rustic and more like primitive kind of look. So it can go any way. Then I'm going to shade it further, make it look real, give it more depth perception and give it more a real kind of a look. So that way my painted door is ready.
Keeping this aside, I have some gold paper and I'm going to cut a big piece. And at the back side, I'm going to draw. So here I wonder if you can see with the glare coming, I just made a face and I'm going to cut it to look like a decorative. And this is going to be the mouth of the dough. So the dough knob shall come here. And then I need some hinges for this dough. I'm going to cut two at the same time. So I'm just folding it so that I get two similar shaped hinge. Just draw a decorative hinge. So I'll have a hinge here and a hinge here. So I'll glue them here. Now next, this is an ordinary pin, thumbtack pin for the notice boards. And I'm going to use this to make the nose and poke it right through this. It depends how you wanted the nose to go. I just made it slightly a little at a slant and then I'm going to paint it. Merge it. So instead of using gold paint, I'm using little bronze color so that I can, you know, make it stand out little differently than the face. Otherwise, on one look, one will not be able to make out what it is. So I'm going to make the rims bronze, the hair bronze, and maybe make something like a mouth here. So that will give some depth to this. Next, I'm using a little bit of black color. And painting the inside of the mouth. Then I'm also making the eyes. And the knobs here. A little more shading just to highlight this.
Wow! Is this Alice in Wonderland?
The talking door? This is so amazing. I just wish it could really talk.
So here is my Alice in Wonderland door and my kids really liked it. I like the face. It's so expressive. It's just so good. I'm going to place it in my kids' room for a little fun that they can have a little door in their wall. Isn't this such a cool craft to do for any kid's room? I think anybody will like it. I like the nose, the mouth, the eyes. It's so cool. For this second DIY, I took a sturdy, strong piece of cardboard. You can take one of those MDF gift tags, and I'm just going to cut it, give it a beautiful shape. A little rounded bottom will be better. It should look like a biscuit or a cookie. So once that is done, I'm going to take my punching machine and punch a hole through it. So this is where I want my hole to come. So I usually take it off. If you have a single puncher, that would be just too awesome. Otherwise, I use my regular punching machine and punch a hole in the perfect place like this. So now I'm going to paint it white or off-white and then be back. So here I have just attached a piece of paper, glued a piece of paper and trimmed off the excess. And then I'm taking some crayons and I'm making this a shading over it as if it's baked piece of biscuit or cookie, baked, freshly baked out of it, slightly browned edges. Brown, and then I'm using some ochre color for a little more depth.
I really thank my old subscribers who return back and support me and encourage me to keep on showing new videos, new DIYs. I thank you so much.
Next, I'm just going to write the words "eat me."
And all my new friends, new people who are stopping by, who are coming here for the first time, if you like the content of my channel, please consider subscribing to my channel by hitting the red subscribe button, and do hit that notification bell twice so that you're notified each time I post my video.
For the final touch, I'm just taking a little jute twine and just bring it through this. And just make a simple loop.
Now this "eat me" sign or tag can be used as a gift tag for cookies or pastries or cakes, cupcakes, or kept near a plate for any party which is for the kids or for Alice in Wonderland themed parties. You can use it. It's a beautiful decor as well as can be a useful tag. If you liked my today's DIY, please give this video a thumbs up, share this video and put down your comments, and if you're new here, please subscribe. I'll see you soon with another DIY next video. Until then, stay positive, be creative, and be happy. Thank you, everybody.